ChronoAgent is a macOS application that runs silently in the background, waiting for incoming connections from ChronoSync or interconnects. To use ChronoAgent, you must first install and configure it on the computer that you want to share data with. If you have not already done this, the ChronoAgent install and setup video provides a quick and easy to follow tutorial. Once ChronoAgent is up and running, the next step is to connect to it. You begin just like you would for any local synchronization. Here we'll create a synchronizer document that performs a backup to the remote ChronoAgent computer. After specifying your home folder as a source target, you need to connect to the ChronoAgent for the destination target. You do this by choosing a connection profile. Initially, there is no connection profile for your ChronoAgent, so you're going to have to create a new one. By choosing Create Connection in the pop-up menu, a new connection profile editor appears. A connection profile is just a collection of settings that define how to communicate with the remote storage service. Start by giving the connection profile a unique name that describes the ChronoAgent you will connect to. When you click the Connection Type pop-up menu, you'll see there are several different storage services to choose from. Since you're connecting to a ChronoAgent, select it from the menu. Now use the Connect To menu to choose the desired ChronoAgent. When you configured your ChronoAgent, you gave it a name. Select that name from this pop-up menu. Authenticate with the credentials you specified when configuring your ChronoAgent. Click Test to make sure you enter the name and password correctly. Now proceed to the Advanced tab by clicking Next. Here you can customize the connection settings based on various factors. We're going to enable data compression because compressing data achieves better performance on Wi-Fi. Now click Next to switch to the Mappings tab. Since ChronoAgent provides full access to the remote file system, it offers the ability to map between users and groups of the two computers. Most of the time, you can just leave these settings at their default, which is exactly what we're going to do here. The connection profile has now been created. Since the profile can be reused for other sync documents, you won't need to worry about creating it again. Selecting the destination target folder is now just as easy as selecting a local folder. The only difference is that you're navigating the file system of the remote computer. Once the destination is selected, you may run the synchronizer document just as you normally would. For more information on ChronoSync and its family of companion products, please visit econtechnologies.com.